Hello friends, this is Deepak from Greece, outdoors, the light keeps shifting, of course there's sound in the background, some from a beautiful running water and some from the airplane, but I thought I would update you on a little idea that I've been toying with and which would address once again the conundrums of mainstream science on the nature of reality. So, what I'm going to suggest to you is that I've said this before, there's no hard problem of consciousness, it's just based on the wrong question. But that's another story. Today, I want to share with you the idea that quantum particles are space-time events in quantum field, and qualia are space-time events in the consciousness field. And there are some very intriguing parallels between the scientific modeling of the universe in quantum physics and the experiential understanding of the universe in non-dual and philosophical traditions. So quantum particles exhibit behaviors such as non-locality, superposition, tunneling, uncertainty, and infinite correlation, which challenge the notions of classical reality. They challenge the classical notions of reality. Similarly, qualia, the subjective experience of consciousness, might be considered to follow analogous principles within a consciousness field. Let me explore this with you. So, first of all, let's look at non-locality. Non-locality in quantum mechanics suggests that particles can be instantly connected regardless of distance. This could be mirrored in the realm of consciousness by the interconnectedness of subjective experiences across individuals or moments. Superposition, where particles exist in multiple states simultaneously, would find a parallel in the multifaceted nature of qualia, where a single experience can encompass various emotions or sensations. Tunneling allows particles to pass through barriers akin to how consciousness can transcend physical limitations through imagination or abstract thought. The uncertainty principle highlights the limits of precision in measuring quantum states. Similarly, qualia are inherently subjective and resist precise quantification. Infinite correlation in quantum systems suggests an underlying unity that could be reflected in the interconnectedness of all conscious experiences. So, viewing quanta and qualia as complementarities posits an entangled relationship between what we call objective reality and subjective experience, suggesting a profound link between consciousness and the fabric of the universe. So actually, let's just conclude this with one caveat. Even quanta are subtle qualia on the screen of consciousness. However, we use quanta to model and create technologies as a result of that modeling, such as this program that you're watching, computers, lasers, artificial intelligence, algorithms, internet, etc., which all actually posit to the fact that everything is inseparably one and interconnected with everything else. So, since quantum fields are considered objective fields, even though they are known subjectively, And particles are considered the building blocks of the universe from an objective point of view. It is actually qualia that are the building blocks of the experience of the universe from a subjective point of view. In every experience, the world of quanta and the world of qualia, the world of the quantum field and the world of the consciousness field are entangled. Cosmos and consciousness go together, and at the ground of all existence, we have access to that quantum, to what scientists call the quantum field of the universe and the quantum body. But subjectively, we have access to the consciousness field, which is the basis of all experience, including the experience of the mind, body, and the physical world, and all these so-called models of reality. So I hope this clarifies how qualia and quanta are entangled in both the appearance and the objective measurement of the universe and the subjective experience of so-called reality, which in turn is a projected reality. So this, what I shared with you, helps us understand the concepts of Maya and Leela and the self of the individual, which is also the self of the universe. I hope this made some sense. Thank you for indulging me in my rambling, and more to come. We are upgrading science right now.